So, isoquants, this is actually, if you know indifference curve, then you can understand isoquants also easily. Indifference curve, what is meant by indifference curve? It is usually for the customers, customer how much benefit or utility or satisfaction is deriving from the product. Okay, so you will be having a scale of preferences under indifference curve. You'll be having various combinations. Only two goods is going to be there. Okay, so two goods will be there. From the two goods, no, he is going to raise his consumption level. And see to that, that both the goods, if he is consuming together, it will give same level of satisfaction. So that's what we discussed under indifference curve. Okay, so that same thing aspect, no, from a producer point of view, if you're going to think, then that is known as isoquants. Okay, so isoquants curve, that is also known as isoquants. Okay, so here producer, their consumer utility you were discussing. No, when consumer, if he has been given combination of two goods. Okay, so if you are going to consume apple and mango or something. Okay, two goods together, then that two goods combination where you will get the same level of satisfaction, same utility we are going to derive there. That represents the indifference curve. Now, isoquant curve, that similar thing, but from a producer aspect. So you are going to use both the products. For your, you are going to use two levels of your inputs here. Okay, two level of inputs you are going to use here. And both the two level of inputs you are going to use means in your production activity, your output level will be the same. So that that will give the maximum productivity or output for that producer or the manufacturer. So isoquant indifference. What is the difference means there from the consumer angle you were thinking about. So which combination like this only we had several combinations. Okay, A, B, C, D like this. We had several combinations and we had two products here. You can pick any two products. See to that, that two products will give you the same level of satisfaction. Okay, so that is from consumer angle we have seen. But this is isoquant, is that from the producer's angle perspective you are going to look into. Here you are going to use two level of inputs, okay. So either labor and capital, two inputs if you are using labor, L it is denoted by, capital K it is denoted by, and you are going to use two inputs here. So that your output, it is remaining constant throughout. Same level of productivity or same level of output you can give. So this is that producer's utility. Producer is going to achieve his maximum output with the combination of these two inputs. So that has been explained under isoquant curve. Okay, so it is a curve. Okay, so the schedule means usually the table that is representing, no, that is known as schedule. Okay, and the graph that we are plotting, no, that is the graphical representation of that. So what it shows means on x-axis labor, two inputs only, no, you are using here. Two inputs use panalo, same level of output you have, you want to get. How their same level of satisfaction you have to get for weight. Indifference curve. Similarly, various inputs, if you use also, you're going to consider only two inputs. There might be lot of inputs, that is the assumption. So lot of inputs you will be using. Okay, so labor, capital, plant and machinery, equipments. Okay, so many things you will be utilizing in your production. But here you are going to pick only two inputs. One is the labor, other one is the capital. You are taking them on the x-axis and y-axis. Okay, and you are going to plot accordingly so that your output level is same throughout. So these are the various possible combinations of that, which gives the producer the same level of output. While varying your level of input, you are going to attain the same level of output. That is known as the isoquant curve. Okay, if you see here, your output is remaining constant throughout. Whatever might be, either you increase your labor, reduce your capital, or reduce your labor, increase your capital, whatever might be, the same level of output if you are achieving means that combination, that graphical representation is known as isokinetic curve, which is otherwise known as isoproduct curve. Quantity means the iso means two inputs they are using. Okay, two inputs they are using, product curve. So quant means quantity of output that they give. Same level of output they are going to give throughout whatever might be their mixer. Same level of output. So that is known as iso quant schedule, iso quant curve. Okay. It's always, if you see isoquant curve, it neither touch the x-axis nor it touch the y-axis. So isoquant map, how you have seen their indifference map, here also isoquant map we have. Indifference map, if you see a collection of all your indifference curve, if you are going to give, that is known as indifference map. Similarly, here also you will have several possible combinations of your input in order to produce the same level of output. So that is known as the isoquant map. Okay. So there we discussed that the curve which is above, no, that gives you higher level of satisfaction. The curve which is lower, no, that gives you lower level of satisfaction. Rather discuss pano. Similarly, here also in isoquant map, this is the higher degree of output that you are going to attain here. This one will be the lower degree of output that you are attaining. Yeah. So this is known as the isoquant map, which comprises of isoquant curves. So assumptions is that always it will give the best possible combination. That is the major assumption. If you are using two inputs, only two inputs you are going to consider. Okay. And then you are going to see that that combination will give you the utmost efficient output. So that is your thing. And here one more thing, term is there, marginal rate of technical substitution. Their marginal rate of substitution word we have come across in indifference curve. In isoquant curve, no, marginal rate of technical substitution, one term we are coming across. So what is meant by marginal substitution means one factor if I am using more, take for example, one factor if I am want to increase, the other factor automatically I will reduce the other one. So that is known as marginal rate of substitution. Indifference curve, when we are coming across, no, that is known as MRS, marginal rate of substitution, where if I want to consume more apples now, I want to reduce one orange there. One more unit of apple, if I want to consume one unit of orange, I have to reduce there. So that is known as marginal rate of substitution there. Okay, you have to sacrifice or lose the other unit. Okay, so your marginal rate of technical substitution and the term inge use panro. So isoquant curve. So why you are using means, if I am using additional labor, one more unit of labor, if I want to increase means, I want to reduce my one unit of capital, I want to reduce here. Or one unit of capital, if I am raising means, one unit of labor, I want to reduce here. So that whatever you are going to lose or sacrifice, no, that is known as the marginal rate of technical substitution. So these are the assumptions of isoquant curve. Okay, only two goods, it is not, two inputs. It is not possible for a manufacturer to have only two inputs in their factors of production. Okay, so that all those things are considered under isoquant curve. So